Imagine yourself in the everyday need of devoting time, effort, or money to produce the oxygen you're going to need for the rest of the day. Needless to say, you'd do it. It's a question of survival. Luckily, it's not necessary. The oxygen we breathe is produced in a natural way. It's an ecosystem service. That is, a benefit we humans obtain from ecosystems. And it's for free. There are several kinds of ecosystem services. Provisioning services, such as fresh water, food, minerals, or some medicines. Cultural services, such as ecotourism, or the pleasure of hiking in the countryside. Regulating services, such as climate regulation, pollination, or carcass removal by scavengers. Beg your pardon, carrion eating is an ecosystem service? Certainly. The removal of carcasses is of great importance for the proper functioning of an ecosystem, and humankind has been directly benefiting from this service since the origin of our species. For instance, the first humans used to observe vultures and hyenas in order to find other animal carcasses for their own consumption. Yes, the first humans were scavengers. Later, after domestication of livestock, scavengers would rapidly remove the dead cattle, preventing diseases spread. There's a great number of animals that can feed themselves from carrion in every ecosystem, ranging from flies and beetles to wolves, foxes, bears, lions, sharks, killer whales, crocodiles. But no doubt, the epitome of the scavenger is the vulture. In Spain, we're lucky enough to count on the largest population of vultures in Europe. There are four species: the cinereus vulture, the griffon vulture, the Egyptian vulture, the bearded vulture. And how efficient they are! They're capable of exploring vast extensions of land. The data provided by the GPS tracking devices installed in griffon vultures from flocks in Cazorla, northeast Andalusia, and Bardenas, Navarre, allow us to see the lengthy journeys they're capable of making in a single day. They go hundreds of kilometers to find carrion from their breeding place. This is what vultures are designed for, and they're the best at it. Yet vulture populations in the world are in danger. The use of poisons, collisions in wind farms, electrocutions in electric lines, the loss and deterioration of their habitat, and the use of some veterinary drugs such as diclofenac are among the main threats for this species. If that weren't enough, a new factor has appeared in the last decades, which threatens vultures' survival. Following the crisis of the mad cow disease, all animal farmers were forced by the European Union to remove the dead cattle carcasses from their fields, the main source of food for vultures. The new regulations stated that carcasses must be transported to treatment plants to be incinerated or converted into other products. In Spain, the substitution of the ecosystem service provided by the vultures meant not only a new worsening of their conservation, but also led to the emission of around 77,000 metric tons of carbon dioxide equivalents, as well as a cost of approximately 50 million euros each year. Don't you think it's time not only to restore the ecosystem services provided by these species, but also to ensure their conservation? Some researchers and managers thought so, and worked together for the European Union to pass a new regulation in 2011 that allows the disposal of livestock carcasses in the most important areas for the scavenger species, which meant a substantial leap forward from the previous scenario. Even so, we keep working so vultures, among other scavengers, are able to dispose of dead cattle free of charge and, that way, enjoy unrestrictedly the show and the beauty of seeing them fly and share our existence with them.